ISUPK.
Hey, Slum, man. It's Priest Kevin Gondonhall with the ISUPK. And the Commander Junior Allen in California, man. To all blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Subscribe to this channel, man. You want true salvation? You're going to learn from the priests and prophets of the ISUPK, man. Subscribe to that channel. Hit that button, man. And it's there with that. Slum.
We want no cowards in our camp, in our camp.
Masters. It's important we understand this, because the Christian church will teach you that you can love money and love God. And the Christian church, they teach that loving money is loving God. Look at these shoes God blessed me with. Who's that pastor that danced all over the money? Look at all this money. And he dancing on the money at the altar. God want me to have this yet, so I can spread the gospel on all four corners of the earth. In the Christian church, they teach the love of money is the love of God, when the Bible says something completely different. If they claim to follow the Bible, why aren't they saying what the Bible says? Read that again.
No man can serve two masters.
No man can serve two masters, man. That's what the Bible says. Keep reading.
For he will hate one and love the other.
For he will hate one and love the other. Is it any surprise that Deshaun Jackson and Nick Cannon apologize? Can you blame him? Can you blame a black man that grew up in oppression selling out his soul for a job, man? We can't laugh at Nick Cannon because brothers do it every day. How many brothers shave their faces and trim their ways? You understand? How many brothers go bald just for a job? How many brothers gotta sell out their soul in some kind of way to make it? Oh, Salaki, so don't wanna forget shaving your beard. How many of us gotta change our voice? On the phone. Right. Hey, sit your tail down. Yes, hello. Yeah, this is, your name is Kendrell. This is Ken. This is he. Right, or stare at your woman when you know she's a hoe, man. How many of us compromise in this place, man? Guess what? We can't serve two masters. You have to be here or be over here, man. And that shouldn't be hard to understand. We operate like that as a people already. You know, and black people, if you got a homeboy and y'all and you beefing with somebody, you're gonna look at him funny if he hanging out the person you beefing with. Hey man, what's up? You can't hang with him and me. That's in the Bible. You can't serve two masters, man. These are the two masters that black people try to serve. Keep reading.
Or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve God.
Ye cannot serve God and
mammon.
And mammon. Anybody know what mammon is? Mammon is money. That bread. That cheddar, that cheese, that dough. That's mammon, man. You can't love money and love God. You have to love one or the other. If you love money, you hate God. And why do you think the Christian church is the way it is? Because they are a religion of people that hate God.
Right.
Christianity is built on hating God. And guess who they teach you to love in the Christian church? Him right here. That white boy. Christianity teaches you to love the white man. That's why it's not so hard for our people to sell out. Because they make it where money is their God. And you can't love money and love God, man. They contradict each other, man. Give me Proverbs 11:4. We got to find out the truth according to this Bible, man. Money has never saved anybody, man. Money has never saved anybody. Money is a defense. But guess what? Brotherhood is a defense. Wisdom is a defense, man. We need more than money to fix black people. The black community has money. The black community is the very reason why the American economy is able to thrive right now. If blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans decided we not buying Jordans no more, there wouldn't be Jordans anymore. They will stop making them. Y'all don't believe me. I'm telling you the truth. The black people said right now, we not wearing Nikes and Adidas no more. Nikes and Adidas would not be a shoe company no more. If black people decided we not going to Chinese restaurants no more, them Chinese people go back to the rice paddies over in Vietnam, in Thailand, and wherever the hell they from. They wouldn't be in Chinatown. They built Chinatown off of that four-piece and fried rye. That four-piece and fried rye and mumbo sauce. You understand? They built their neighborhoods and communities off the backs and the money and the love of our people, man. That's what we gotta understand. We should not seek riches in this place, man. Money is not our issue. Integrity is our issue. Brotherhood is our issue, man. What does it mean if we got money and we still murdering each other, man? What does it mean if we got houses and we got businesses and we still hating each other, man? We have to love each other and love each other according to the Bible, man. We have to follow this Bible. And the Bible says you can't serve two masters. Read where you at.
Oh, God.
Proverbs 11 and 4. Riches profit not in the day of wrath.
Read that again.
Riches profit not in the day of wrath. The Bible says riches profit not in the day of wrath, man. That's something we gotta understand. That's something I wish Nick Cannon would have understood. If he would have came and got counsel from the ISUBK under Commanding General Yohana, he would have understood this if the Lord would allow him to understand it. Riches profit nothing in the day of wrath. There's a day coming when your money is not going to save you. There's a day coming where that money is not going to let you live a life that's great.
Right.
Do you know, in Louisville, Kentucky, 4 black celebrities were arrested. I don't know if y'all know. They had a protest in Louisville, Kentucky for Breonna Taylor. And it's about 87 protesters. They went to the attorney general's house and protested in his at his yard. And the police gave all of them felonies. They arrested them and they got charged with felonies. Con Gerald gave all of them felonies. Out of those 87 black people that was protesting, 4 of them were celebrities. One that was from, what's her name? Portia from the Real Housewives. I don't watch that, you know. That's more, you know, garbage. Right. The water, you know. Of course, another Viacom company where they make money selling us a dream of destruction, man. They put on a TV loudmouth black women and gangbanging drug dealing black men, and it inspires our people to go and do that. One of the sisters that was arrested was the sister from Real Housewives. One of the sisters, she was from the other one's from Love and Hip Hop New York. There's another brother, YBN Cordae, he's a rapper. And there's another one. What we should find out by now, it doesn't matter if you're a celebrity. Now, the water general, no charges on no police officers that murdered Breonna Taylor, but the protesters asking for justice are put in jail and charged with felonies, man. The white man is the devil, the Bible speaks of, man. And we can't see that by now, man. The Christian church has really destroyed our people. The Christian church has did a number on our people, man. We keep trying to love and the white man, man. It goes hand in hand, man. The Christian church and the white man go hand in hand. You know why? Because Christianity is white supremacy. When you are a Christian, you're the same religion as the KKK. The KKK members used to burn crosses on the yards of black men, of black families. You know why? Because they were good, Bible-toting, Jesus loves me, Baptist Christians. When you go to church, you are doing what the KKK do. You know, Donald Trump is a Christian. Donald Trump is an absolute Christian, man. All the Italian mobsters, they were Christians. They murdered all them people in the 30s and 20s, and they were Christians. They all got baptized. Christianity is not good for black people. It doesn't fix our people, it doesn't change our people. And the moment we understand that, we will come back to our culture according to this Bible, man. Give me Jeremiah 23 and 25, man. These pastors are the reason why we're destroyed, because they do the will of the white man in America, man. They teach black men, black women to come up against their man. They teach black men to be effeminate and to be drug addicts, man. That's why they push the drugs in the black community. I never hear a pastor speak against drug addiction. I never hear a pastor speak against drug use. But he'll take that drug money, General. Come on, sir. The water, sir. But he'll take that drug money. They love it. Listen, just bring it to the church. God will clean the money. God will work it all out, brother. How about you pay 20% to this dirty? And the brother gonna pay the 20%, because in his head, he doing what he think he had to do to be righteous. The pastor is taking advantage of our people. These Christians have been lying to black people, man. And the biggest lie of them all was our beloved Martin Luther King Jr. Everybody loves to bring up Martin Luther King Jr. He did so much for black people. He told black people to wait. And guess what? We find it out now, Martin Luther King Jr. was a sexual deviant who didn't give a damn about black people. Martin Luther King Jr. was a person who only was in power for his own gain. Martin Luther King destroyed the black economy with one speech, man. You know, before Martin Luther King, we had black businesses. Black women did black women's hair. Black women did their nails. Black men made shoes. Black men made belts. We had black industries, said again, sir. Black airports, black movie theaters. They act like we were so broke and poor before the civil rights movement. Man, you know we were thriving. You know the first woman millionaire in America was a black woman, Madam C.J. Walker, man. The first woman millionaire out of the white women, Asian women, African, Arab women, the first woman millionaire was a black woman. You know why? Because black business thrives when we give to our own people. One Christian speech destroyed all that, man. And because of that, we're destroyed. Martin Luther King, according to the Bible, is a liar. And I can prove it. The Bible prophesied Martin Luther King lying. And we should have never followed him, man. We should have never listened to his so-called dream. Martin Luther King destroyed black business, man. And because of that, our women got to get beat upside the head in the nail salons by Asian women. We got to go to Chinese restaurants where they hate us. We got to go to Arabs that's molesting our children, soliciting sex from 14-year-old girls. We got to go to Africans who stink, you know what I'm saying, selling us some knockoff bags. That's the crime in itself, man. And when it wasn't like that before. And Martin Luther King Jr. is the reason behind that. And the Bible prophesied him being a liar. It's in the Bible. I can prove it to you. You don't believe me, it's right here in the book that everybody's scared to pick up and read. We read it back here because we care about the truth. Damn right. Let's read that, brother. The book of Jeremiah 23, verse 25. I have heard what the prophet said that prophesied lies in my...
Hold up. Slow down. We talking about Martin Luther King Jr. now. Beloved Michael. What's the title again? The late, great, the good Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., man. You can't tell a black woman nothing about good old Mike. Martin Luther King Jr. is Christ's son to black people. But guess what? The Bible says something different. Read that again.
Okay. I have heard what the prophet said that prophesied lies in my name.
The Bible says, I have heard what the prophets say, man. Martin Luther King Jr. was a so-called prophet to black people, man. Martin Luther King Jr. was a Christian pastor, the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King. He was a pastor, so-called prophet. And the Bible says he heard the prophet prophesying what?
Lies in my name.
Prophesying what?
Lies in my name.
The Bible says he has heard the prophet prophesying lies in my name. Who does that sound like to you today? Prophesying lies, saying God told me to tell you. God told me to tell you, just turn it around, get it ready. I told you, God's going to break it through. You know what that sound like? Look, some of y'all was enjoying that. That's not this back here. This ain't that. Yeah, they thought they get it popping over here. Yeah, start clapping, amen, not back here. Because we tell the truth, and the truth stinks. They right, that nigga spitting. You know what I'm saying, right? Why every pastor sounds like something caught in their throat, man? Why you gotta talk like that, man?
That's not necessary, but you know why? Because it's a show. It's to get you riled up. A show of lies. And the Bible just said that. Read it again.
God. I have heard what the prophet said. They prophesied lies.
They prophesied lies, man. Lies. God doesn't love everybody. Christ is not white. The Jews are black, man. Christ is black. God doesn't love everybody. God loves one set of people, and that's the 12 tribes of Israel. The real Jews, according to the Bible. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. But we've been lied to and believe that God loves the oppressor. So God loves the murderer and the victims of murder, huh? So God loves the rapist and the victim of rapes, huh? And that's not how that works, man. God loves only our people. Keep reading.
Saying, I have dreamed.
Hold up. Now we're talking about Martin Luther King Jr. Martin Luther King Jr. came and gave a speech right here in D.C. And his famous speech, who can start it off? Everybody know it. What's Martin Luther King Jr.'s most famous speech? Say it again, brother. I have a dream. You know he's a pastor because he did that voice thing again, General. It's God. I have a dream, brother. Read that again. And you're right, brother. Get that brother a hand, man. Get that brother a hand for having the courage to tell the truth. Because that's hard to find these days, apparently. You understand? Drop that scripture again, man.
Saying, I have heard what the prophet said. They prophesied lies in my name. Saying, I have dreamed.
I have what?
I have dreamed.
I have what?
I have dreamed.
The brother just brought it out. Martin Luther King Jr.'s most famous speech that got us to give up all our businesses was I have a dream that little black boys and little white girls can hold hands at the table of brotherhood. The Bible says this is a lie, man.
That's right.
The Bible says Martin Luther King Jr.'s dream was a goddamn lie.
That's right.
We living it right now. Where's the dream? Are we living a dream? The water, General. Nightmare, man. Are we living a dream, man? We live in a nightmare. The Bible prophesied Martin Luther King Jr. lying to the black community. You gotta ask yourself, why would he lie to us? Why would he do that to us? Why would he say that? You know why? Because you cannot serve two masters. You will love one and hate the other. And because Martin Luther King Jr. loved white whores and loved money, who's his master, man? The so-called the oppressor, Constance Lockett. The white man was Martin Luther King Jr.'s master. He loved America and the white man more than he loved you, black man. More than he loved you, Hispanic, Native American, Indian man. Just like, Nick Cannon. Oprah, Gail, Jada Pinkett, with her whore self, even Will Smith, man. Our celebrities and entertainers and religious leaders love money more than they love the people. That's why the people are suffering, why they have all the money. Because they're not giving them to the people, man. We made the Christian church rich, and we still live in the ghettos. We still have to, our kids, listen, feel this for a second. When the COVID-19 hit, and I say this all the time, because this is a mind blowing to me, and I knew this growing up because I experienced it, but to see it happen to little kids, it's different, it hit different. Do you know, when the school let out for the COVID-19, the school system had to still provide lunches for the kids. Anybody know why? Does anybody know why when the COVID-19 shut down the schools, why did the schools have to still provide lunches? I'll tell you why. Because black, Hispanic, and Native American children would not eat if they didn't get lunch at school. Because we live in such hell in America. Because we live in such oppression in this place. Our children would not eat if they didn't go to school. I remember it. I remember growing up. My mom used to be mad every time we had an off day or snow day. Because, or the summertime, the water, General, you know why? Because she knew, God damn, how I'm gonna feed these kids, man? How these kids gonna eat? That's the life we live. While they buy Lamborghini trucks for their wives. While they buy Birkin bags for their toddlers. While they go and spend money on all type of garbage, man. We live in hell.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain, And a lot of sorrow, got betrayed so packed I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's hereditary from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good record. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how did you excel? With them the breath of life, I don't believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain, something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword. With